Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching TopTenzNet, and in the video today, we're looking at the top 10 theories about why the Neanderthals died out. Homo sapiens and Homo neanderthalensis, or humans and Neanderthals, started to diverge from a common ancestor, Homo erectus, about 700,000 years ago. Then our species completely branched off about 300,000 years ago. On average, Neanderthals were shorter than humans, and they had a stockier build. They also had angled cheekbones, prominent brow ridges, and wide noses. Like humans, they used tools, they controlled fire, and they buried their dead. And while they are often depicted as dumb, savage brutes, researchers believe they were as intelligent as humans. They lived in Eurasia, from about Spain to western Siberia, and while the date of their extinction is debated, it's believed that they died out somewhere between 30 to 42,000 years ago. Why they went extinct is one of the biggest mysteries in evolutionary science. So why did our ancestral cousins die out? Number 10. We were better hunters. The Neanderthals went extinct not long after humans migrated out of Africa into Eurasia. The Neanderthals ruled Europe for a long time before the arrival of humans, and they suddenly died off after coming into contact with them. This has led researchers to believe that humans were somehow responsible, at least in part, for their extinction. One theory as to how humans drove Neanderthals to extinction was because we were better hunters. This became a problem because with only limited amounts of food, there would have been competition for it. Since we're here and, well, they aren't, it would suggest that we were better hunters and got most of the food. This would have caused the Neanderthal population to plummet, while the human population would have gone up. Number 9. Humans violently replaced them. Over history, humans have had a tendency to kill, enslave, or conquer other groups of people who are different from them. So why would prehistoric humans be any different when they came into contact with the Neanderthals? When humans migrated out of Africa, they may have been more aggressive and more violent than the Neanderthals because this was advantageous to their hunting style. Meanwhile, it's believed the Neanderthals were less violent because they didn't hunt in the same way. Instead of hunting and chasing down big animals to get their protein, they ate insects. If they were more peaceful by nature, the Neanderthals would have been unable to fight off the growing population of violent human brutes who invaded their territory. Number 8. Volcanic eruption. An event that can have profound effects on the Earth is the eruption of a large volcano. When a volcano erupts, millions of cubic tons of ash and debris can be put into the atmosphere, and this alters the climate of the Earth by making it cooler because less sun reaches the Earth. Well, 39,000 years ago, around the same time that the Neanderthals went extinct, the Campi Flegrei volcano, west of Naples, Italy, had a massive eruption. It was the biggest eruption in Europe in 200,000 years, and 60 cubic miles of ash were pumped into the atmosphere. This would have had devastating effects on the Neanderthals. The sun would have been blotted out for months, if not years. This would have cooled temperatures in Europe, and it would have brought on acid rain. These types of conditions would have made the environment inhospitable to the Neanderthals, causing them to die out. As the ash dispersed and the Neanderthals were dying off, humans would have moved into Europe with little resistance. Number 7. Humans hunted with wolves. Around the time that the Neanderthals went extinct, there were three top predators competing for food in Europe: the Neanderthals, humans, and wolves. According to anthropologist Pat Shipman of Pennsylvania State University, an alliance between the wolves and the humans led to the extinction of the Neanderthals. His theory is that humans were able to tame and breed wolves. These wolf dogs would have been used to get large animals like mammoths cornered so the humans could finish them off. Cornering the animal was the most dangerous part of the hunt. Also, when humans would bring down the animals and start to cut them apart, they had to fight off scavengers. The wolves would have been able to sense these scavengers from longer distances, and they would have scared them off. Then the humans would feed the wolves, and this would have been a win-win situation for the two top predators. Meanwhile, there is no evidence that the Neanderthals used wolves to hunt. Without their help, prey would have been more dangerous to hunt, and they would have to exert more energy while hunting, meaning they needed more food to sustain themselves. This would have made it hard for the Neanderthal population to maintain and grow their population, especially when their two competitors teamed up to fight for the same resources that they also needed. Number 6. We had more culture. According to a mathematical model from Stanford University, the reasons that humans are still around and the Neanderthals aren't is that humans had a high level of culture. By having a stronger culture, they would have been able to hunt and gather food over a larger area than the Neanderthals. This culture would have also led to better tool-making skills, which would allow them to make better weapons. For example, an axe would have been an incredibly useful tool and a devastating weapon. According to their model, a small population of humans with a high level of culture could have overwhelmed a large population of Neanderthals who were less cultured. Number 5. The division of labor. The Neanderthals didn't have the most complex diet. They were known to hunt big game animals, which was a dangerous task. They also hunted differently than humans. Neanderthal men, women, and juveniles would get involved in the hunt. Humans, on the other hand, developed tasks based on age and gender. This division of labor allowed them to collect a variety of different foods, and they could then process and cook these foods. Being able to eat a variety of cooked food would have given humans an evolutionary edge in two ways. The first is that they would have had more sources for food. Secondly, the more complex diet of cooked food not only allowed humans to survive, but it also helped in the evolution of the human brain and helped make it what it is today. Number 4. Neanderthals had smaller frontal lobes. One of the prevailing misconceptions surrounding the Neanderthals is that we were smarter than them. However, researchers believe their brains were just as big as humans, but they were built very differently. Neanderthal brains were designed to control large bodies and to track movement. Humans had larger frontal lobes, which is the region of the brain where decision-making, social behavior, creativity, and abstract thought are controlled. In the long run, these qualities probably gave us an evolutionary edge compared to the Neanderthals. For example, by using abstract thought, humans realized that by processing foods, like smashing up cooked yams, it would have saved energy during the eating process because you need less energy to chew your food. This is especially important when raising children. Secondly, the frontal lobe would have been helpful in spreading new technology quickly. With a larger frontal lobe, it would have been easier for humans to teach each other and to learn. Also, thanks to the large frontal lobe, early humans saw the benefit in forming large social groups, and these large groups would have made technology easier to spread across the species. By saving energy on everyday tasks like eating and utilizing technology, it would have given us an evolutionary edge that allowed us to survive while the Neanderthals went extinct. Number 3. The weather change changed their habitat. An argument against the replacement theory is that humans had nothing to do with the extinction of the Neanderthals. After all, humans first left Africa about 100,000 years ago and moved into the Middle East, and then about 60,000 years ago they made it to Australia. However, humans only migrated into Europe, the Neanderthals' homeland, 45,000 years ago. The question is, why did humans travel all the way down to Australia before getting to Europe, which is essentially around the corner from the Middle East? This suggests that humans may have only been able to move when the Neanderthals were already dying off. So the big question then is, well, why were they dying off? Well, drastic weather change could have been the culprit. When the Neanderthals went extinct, the last ice age was coming to an end, and Eurasia was experiencing unstable weather patterns which dramatically changed the landscape. For example, in Italy, around the time the Neanderthals went extinct, forests morphed into open plains over the span of 100 years. The Neanderthal body simply couldn't evolve fast enough to survive in the new landscape. The problem was that the Neanderthals hunted in the forest. They used the trees as cover, and then they clubbed or stabbed their prey. Their bodies simply weren't built to sneak up on fast-moving and dangerous game animals in the newly developed open plains. Humans, on the other hand, were used to grasslands and open fields because that was the terrain in Africa where humans evolved and strived. With the Neanderthal population dwindling and the landscape becoming advantageous to human skills, our ancestors simply moved into the area. Number 2. Disease wiped them out. Why the Neanderthals lived for tens of thousands of years in Eurasia but died out about 1,000 to 5,000 years after coming into contact with humans is one of the most debated topics in anthropology. The obvious conclusion is that humans did have something to do with the extinction, but no one is sure why or how humans caused it. One theory is that when the Neanderthals moved out of Africa and settled in Eurasia, their immune system developed to deal with that environment. However, when humans migrated out of Africa, they brought African pathogens with them, and these caused diseases like tuberculosis, herpes, tapeworms, and stomach ulcers. The Neanderthals' immune systems simply couldn't deal with these diseases, and they went extinct. Yep, you heard that right. Humans gave the Neanderthals herpes, and it killed them. Evidence to back this up is that this is what happened when Europeans came to the Americas starting in 1492. When they came, they brought diseases like smallpox and malaria, and this was devastating to people in the Americas. Since the Native Americans' immune systems weren't developed to combat these diseases, it's estimated that 20 million Native Americans were killed in the years following contact with the Europeans. This was nearly 95% of their population in the Americas. Number 1. They assimilated with humans. One theory surrounding the fate of the Neanderthals is that there was no death blow. They simply assimilated with humans by interbreeding. For any of the reasons listed in the other entries in this video, or quite possibly because of a combination of them, the population of Neanderthals became drastically low. However, instead of them just dying off, the species could have been absorbed by the much bigger human population. Evidence to back this up is that if you were born outside of Africa, 1.5 to 2.1% of your DNA is Neanderthal in origin. However, what's interesting is that it isn't the same genes in everyone. For example, if you have 2% Neanderthal DNA and your next door neighbor has 2% Neanderthal DNA, you may not share the same 2%. Researchers think that 20% of the Neanderthal genome is still found within humans. So they never exactly went extinct. Instead, their DNA just became part of the modern human genome. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that like button below. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, over there on the right, a couple of other videos that you might enjoy if you enjoyed this one. And thank you for watching.